happy birthday. Born on the 13th of February. Wow, that's a very good horoscope to have. You are very inventive and you're on the borderline of being a genius because you understand all futuristic movements through the IT or through your inner senses. And as I said, I would call you an inventor and a near genius as you get older. It's a horoscope that has a character of a very rebellious person. That's because most of us are brought up in a traditional manner, and your horoscope doesn't like that. And your horoscope wants to outreach into the unknown areas, and so you will be in rebellious areas where you want to break rules and regulations. But that's how you are. A genius needs to break rules and regulations, but you have to be sensible as well. You cannot totally go against traditional rules and values. So find the middle path and you will do very well for yourself, born on the 13th of February. You will have a character, as I said, of rebelliousness, a loner, a person who likes his own company the best. No harm with that. But you also need partnerships. So you have to pull your socks up and say, I have to improve myself to attract partnerships. Why? Because you will tend to be arrogant. You will tend to be having very little tolerance for others. And that usually results in very poor teamwork. And how can you achieve things on a big scale if you don't have support in the form of a team? So try to correct a little bit of this situation. You have marketing skills. You have communication skills. You have inventive skills. You have a long-term planet that wants to give you a very nice long life as well. And you have planets that want to make you a professional. Lawyer, doctor, architect, engineer, a professional. So you have a lot of good scope. And you have the imagination and the creativity as well. The problem basically is your level of arrogance, low tolerance, a tendency to be very secretive, dominating, and a little moody as well. So try and control those areas. Regarding compatibility, as I said, you are not an easily compatible person, but you must start to value teamwork and partnerships, whether in areas of romance or marriage or career or business. Partnerships are very important. You cannot be a superman trying to do everything yourself. I want to talk to you about 2017. Now, the planets who rule the calendar year 2017 are not very friendly to you, born on the 13th of February. And so you have lost about 30 or 35% of good energy or support. Well, you still have 65 or 70% to your favor. But let's see now. I'm going to see you born on the 13th of February. I'm going to give you a set of good ages that you might be in 2017. So let's pretend that you are the ages of 22 or 31 or 40 or 49 or 58 or 67 or 75, is it 67 or 76? Or 85. Now, if you are any of these ages in 2017, then you are still going to do very well. And you will be a person who will make great inroads into career business, or even if you are still studying, you will do very well also in career business. You'll find romance very easily, and you'll be able to fix yourself up if you want to marry or have business partnerships or good results in your career. So you'll be a lucky person if you are of any of these ages which I've just mentioned. But I'm going to give you another set of ages. Now let's pretend that you are the ages of 16 or 25 or 34 or 43 or 52 or 61 or 70 or 79. Now, if you happen to be any of these ages in 2017, you have to minimize and lower your exposure to risk. Whether the exposure to risk is to your romance or marriage, whether to your career or business or finances in general, and even danger of accidents, minimize your exposure to risk, because there is a cluster of negative planets who, from your age side, wants to carry on and be very friendly with the calendar year planets, and together they will try to find ways and means of how to put obstacles and hurdles and bring provocation against you. Now that you know, and if you happen to be of these ages that you know, well, you can start to become very careful and minimize your exposure to risk, and you will still make 2017 a good enough year for you. If you don't happen to be of any of these ages which I've mentioned, the good or the bad, then you are going to be of an age which will have its ups and downs, but not to the extreme like these two examples which I've given you. Regarding your health, knowing that you are born on the 13th of February, that's all I know, very little bits of information. I don't know your year of birth, nor do I know your time of birth, nor have I looked at your palms. Your palms are your DNA. The fingerprints and the thumbprints you have, nobody else in the world can ever have, and the lines and the signs, the way their palms are formed, exclusively yours. So when I see your palms, I can be very accurate on a long-term basis. But for the time being, knowing that you're born on the 13th of February, I'm a bit worried that you are a mystery to doctors. Not many doctors will be able to find out what's wrong with you. And when you point to some part of your body and say that hurts, they will of course do the x-rays and the MRIs, and they won't be able to find much. So you have to be your own specialist doctor, and you have to take note of where it hurts, go to the internet, find out what, if it hurts here, what organ is there, so that you know all that. And then write these things down and help your doctor that way. But there are a few things which I can pick up. I am worried that your level of diabetes is going to get out of control one day. So if your parents or grandparents have it, then it's coming down to you. But if they don't have it, don't celebrate too quickly. Do a blood test, a blood sugar blood test, and then we'll find out from there. And also blood test your pancreas. One of the duties of your pancreas is to produce insulin for your body. And if it is not well, how can it produce insulin for you? So the doctors will have to give you some medicine for your pancreas. But go that way. The other thing I worry about is allergies. You are going to have allergies. And there are four kinds of allergies I worry about for you. One is to your skin. One is to your breathing, which we call sinusitis. One is to your eyes, they get very itchy or they go red. And one is to your stomach. The word gastric was not in the old days, there was no such word. So in the old days, it would be thought that you have allergy problems to your stomach, which now they call gastric. So don't take too much chili, because chili produces a lot of gas in your stomach anyway. Now, apart from allergies, there's one other thing about blood circulation. Your feet are complaining. So if the feet complain, it could be the diabetic problem, because that's linked to the feet, or it could be that your blood flow is not too well. So there's a thing in the East called foot reflexology, where they, under the soles of your feet, where most of the organs in your body are represented. And when the specialist does that, he's giving energy to many of your organs, or get somebody to massage your feet, or massage them yourself. Okay, these are the few things which I worry about for you. If I have your full date of birth, including your time of birth and your time of birth, and look at your palms, I'll be able to do a whole list for you as to what can go wrong, and that would be good, because that means early detection is what I do. Regarding travel, you will be a great traveler. You will always choose the most outlandish and places to go to where others don't even think of. You'll also be a person who is an adventurer and would like to associate some kind of risk to wherever you go, because that brings excitement to you. Well, you will be a great traveler, and the only thing is, be a bit cautious as to not wanting to take too much risk along with you wherever you travel to. Regarding migration, you will have every chance of migrating if that's what you want. And you'll be able to, by the time you're ages of 31 onwards, migration can become active in your life, and settling down with foreigners or people of another race in foreign countries, all that is going to be part of your life. So make the effort, okay? Regarding meditation, off the bat, you will not be very interested in this, because tradition is a traditional way of allowing good energy to come into you. Well, think about it. And if you are going to meditate, don't get into positions you see in magazines like yoga exercises. You don't have to do that. You can sit on a sofa and either with your eyes closed or your eyes open and try to channel your energy and focus on what you want to focus. And that is in itself meditation. You can do it while lying down in bed. You can do it while standing up. All that can be done in any form. Don't become a clone where you want to follow the way other people are doing. Okay? Now, I would suggest this, that while you are meditating, your thumb and your middle finger should meet like this, both hands. The middle finger is the finger of Saturn. This planet is very active in your horoscope and very positive as well, wants to help you in all areas of life. So when you do this, two things are happening. One is you are getting the mighty thumb to join up with this finger, and that is like sending off a huge bolt of good energy into you. And the other good thing you are doing for yourself is creating infinity. Infinity means forever. So the energy that comes to your thumb like this circles back through the middle finger to you. It doesn't escape and be wasted. And so doing this for any length of time, even if you're going for a walk, do this while you're walking, and you will be able to gain that momentum of energy build up, which may just bring that brilliant idea that you want, or bring that brilliant motivation that you need. So do that. And the other thing is, you can do this while facing a good direction. Now, born on the 13th of February, one of the good directions I like for you is southwest. You've got two directions. So first one, southwest. So if you are sitting down or standing up or lying down, if you're lying down, then the soles of your feet must face this good direction, southwest. Because when you are asleep and your eyes are closed and your mind is well asleep, the energy must come through you, not anymore through elsewhere, but through the soles of your feet. So face southwest. The other good direction for you to face is west. So from southwest to west, that corridor of energy is immense for you. Try these things out. You have a fascinating birth date, born on the 13th. You are the inventor. You are the futuristic person. You are the one who can see how things should be done and how they will be done in the future. 50, 60, 70, 80 years ago, when there was comics and they drew watches on the hands of people which were actually TVs, and we all laughed at it. These people who were doing this, who were illustrators or who were writers for the comics, they must have had a horoscope like yours, who can have these fantastic ideas. Well, it was good talking to you. Do go to Facebook. And when you're on Facebook, search for Andi, A-N-D-I, dot Singh, S-I-N-G-H, dot 9, the number 9, dot Facebook.com. And it'll bring you straight to where I am on Facebook. And then we can communicate. Follow me and we can communicate. And you can ask me all the questions you want. And one day we may be able to Skype. And I'm already doing that with some clients all over the world. And we can Skype. It will cost you USD 50. And I'll give you 75 to 90 minutes of my time on Skype. And you'll be able to show me your palms as well. And I can do a full horoscope for you one day. Until then, happy birthday, good luck, and goodbye.